वेलकम फ्रेंड्स, माई सेल्फ संदीप पटेल, लेक्चर इन कंप्यूटर इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट एट वल्लभ बुद्धि पॉलिटेक्निक मुंबई। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न द ओवरऑल इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर इन जावा प्रोग्रामिंग। एज इन आवर प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी सी द ओवरलोडिंग ऑफ मेथड। ओके, इन दैट स्ट्रक्चर व्हाट हैपन, देयर इज अ मोर देन टू मेथड विद द सेम नेम एंड इन द सेम क्लास। ओके, दिस स्ट्रक्चर इज डायरेक्टली अप्लाइड फॉर अ स्ट्रक्चर। In this program, we can see there is a more than two constructor with the same name is declared. Okay. Now here you can see the class name is box. Okay. Then what we do? We take three variable of double width, double height, and double depth. Then after we create a constructor. Okay. Constructor means same name as a class name. But this constructor do not have any data type. Okay? This constructor pass three parameters. One is double W, double H, and double D. These three parameters pass the constructor box. Now, in the body of this constructor, we just allocate value of W to width, H to height, and D to depth. Okay, and we close this constructor. Now then after we take another constructor, same name as a class name, box. Okay, it is a second constructor with no parameter. This constructor does not contain any parameter. It simply places the value of width is equal to minus 1, height is equal to minus 1, and depth is equal to minus 1. Okay, then after we take another constructor, okay, with the parameter 1. Okay, we take one parameter, double length, and in this block we take width is equal to height is equal to depth is equal to length. Okay, now then we take one method, double volume. This method return the value of width into height into depth. Okay, so you can see there is a 1, 2, and 3 box, that means constructor are declared in the same class. This structure is called as a overloading constructor. Now the question arises that how we can differentiate this constructor. For that we can see in first constructor we declare three parameters. In second we do not declare any parameter. In third constructor we declare one parameter. So by declaring a parameter in the constructor we can differentiate all the overloading constructor. Okay, now come on to our program. The another class we take overload from. In that class we take main method, public string, void main, string arg. Then we create numbers of object for box class. Okay, the first is box, my box 1 is equal to new box. Okay, now you can see here is a constructor that pass three parameters. So program go to the constructor that have three parameters, that is here. Okay, it simply gives value W to 10, H to 20, and D to 50. It is compulsory give in a sequence. Okay, and finally this value give to width, height, and depth. Okay, so for my box 1, for my box 1, the value of width for my box 1, value of width is 10. Okay, for height, my box 1 dot height value is 20, my box 1 dot depth is equal to 50. Okay, now program execute this statement. Box my box 2 is equal to new box. Okay, the second object my box 2 is equal to new, and this is a constructor box with no parameter. So program go to the constructor that do not have any parameter. So here, okay, we can see there is no parameter in this constructor. So the value of width gives minus 1, height is equal to minus 1, depth is equal to minus 1. So for my box 2, my box 2, the value of width is equal to minus 1. For height, it is also minus 1. For depth, it is also minus 1. Okay? Now then, we execute this statement. Box, my box 3 is equal to new box in bracket 1 parameter is transfer. So, program is transferred to this constructor. Okay? Because this constructor have one parameter. In this constructor, we equal all variable value with len value. Okay? So, the box pass 7. So, len is equal to 7. And height, width, depth is equal to len. So, my box 3 dot width is equal to 7. My box 3 dot height is equal to 7. My box 3 dot depth is equal to 7. Okay? By this way, we can give a value to each object with our value. Okay? Now, there is a one variable declared wall with the data type double. Okay? Now, what we do? Wall is equal to mybox1 dot volume method is called. Now, there is a volume method is also placed in our class box. So, the program is go to the volume method at here. Okay? This program is, this statement is mybox1 dot volume. So, the value of mybox1, the value of my box 1 for width, height and depth is go to volume method and do multiplication and return the answer. Okay? So, for volume, for first my box 1, it is a 10 into, it is a 10 into 20 into 15. So, it is a 3000. Okay? It is printed. Now then second, volume is equal to, wall is equal to my box 2 dot volume. So program is equal to, again find volume method with the value of box 2, my box 2 class, that is minus 1, minus 1, minus 1. So the second answer is minus 1. Then wall is equal to my box 3 dot volume. Okay. So again, this volume method is called with the value of my box 3, that is 7, 7. Answer 3, 4, 3. Okay. By this way, we can perform our overloading constructor. In this method, we take three constructor. You can do this example with two constructor also or four constructor also. Okay. I hope you will understand better from this example. Thank you.